Hello, and welcome to the Azure Troubleshooting Series. Today, we will show you how we troubleshoot connectivity issues to virtual machines. In our scenario today, we have a virtual network, a source VM, and a destination VM. First, let's go into the destination VM that's hosting the web app. We're going to make note of two things. The first is the IP address that we want to connect to. The second, let's make note of the status and make sure this virtual machine is running. Next, in the left pane, scroll all the way to the bottom. Under Support and Troubleshooting, select Connection Troubleshoot. Here, we're testing inbound connections, and we want to set our connection source. So let's choose Other IP address, and let's put in here the IP address of our source. And we're connecting today HTTP. Port 80 TCP test connection. After a few seconds, we see that the network connectivity is blocked by security group rule, user rule, deny connection from source. To resolve this, we select this link that also gives us a little tip on how to resolve the issue. So we're looking for the name that matches the connection error we saw, and here it is, deny connection from source. So for the sake of this example, I'm going to go ahead and allow traffic with this security rule. While that's updating, we need to do one other thing. Let's go to our source VM, and we're going to do something similar. In the left pane, we're going to scroll to the bottom. Under Support and Troubleshooting, we're going to select Connection Troubleshoot. This time, we're going to select Outbound Connections. Now we need to select our connection destination. So we need to go and put in the IP address of our destination VM. And again, we're going to select HTTP, port 80 TCP test connection. And from the perspective of the source VM, it looks like everything is good to go. So now let's test our connection to our web app. Here, from the source, I was trying to connect to the web app on the destination VM. Let's refresh and see if it works. And you can see I can now connect to my web app. The next most common issue we see is a user-defined route, or UDR, redirecting traffic incorrectly or to a misconfigured network virtual appliance. First, let's go here to the source VM, and let's just verify the region that it's in, North Central US for mine. Next, let's go search for Network Watcher. Let's select it. You should see a region listed where your source VM is. If not, you can add it by selecting Add. In the left-hand pane, let's select Next Hop. Here, you'll want to fill out the resource group, source VM, network interface, and source IP. I need to fill in the destination IP address, 10.4.0.5. That's the virtual machine hosting our web app. Select Next Hop. Our result for our next hop type is none. This is interesting. I expect this to say virtual network, meaning that my next hop is just on the virtual network directly to my destination IP. But here I can see IP address is a dot ending in a dot six. So we need to investigate this a little bit further. So I know now there is a user defined route. So what we need to do is go back to our source VM, select networking, select network interface. In the left hand pane, scroll to the bottom and select effective routes. Now what we're going to be looking for in the table that appears here is we're going to be looking for a source of user. If you select the title source twice, all your user defined routes will come to the top. Here we can see that anything that is destined for my .5 address is actually getting redirected to .6 address. So to fix this, let's go to the associated route table and select routes in the left-hand pane. And here we need to delete this route. Delete this route or go to our virtual appliance and fix the configuration on our virtual appliance. For this example, we'll just delete this. Next, let's go to our source and see if we can resolve to our web app. And again, our web app is now available. Lastly, let's check to ensure that the destination VM ports are responding to TCP requests. First, let's go to the virtual network that our destination VM is in. Let's go to, in the left-hand pane, let's go to Diagnose and Solve Problems. Let's scroll down a little bit until you can see connectivity and select it. In the drop-down, select Unable to reach a port, and let's fill in the information on this diagnostic. Let's choose our destination VM, and let's select the port we're trying to connect to, and then let's select Submit. The first time you run this, this may take a few minutes. The result shows us here that the VM firewall or application is causing connection issues. Let's follow the instructions below to resolve the issue. So we're going to log into the destination VM and we're going to run netstat.ano. So we want to start, get into the command prompt. We're going to run netstat space dash ano. And what we're looking for here is we're looking for TCP port 80 listening. So here's our protocol, here's our port numbers. And I do not see port 80 with a status of listening. Let's check IIS and make sure it started. Oh, sure enough, IIS is not started. Let's start it. And then let's check this again. So I'm hitting up arrow and enter. And here we go. I have TCP port 80 and it's in a listening status. So let's go back to this connectivity diagnostic to check the VM ports and let's check again, let's see what we get. And it looks like our result is good. This check completed without reporting any problems. So let's go to our source VM and let's refresh the page to see if we can connect to the web app. And there we go. The web app is now accessible.